Thank you. So I have the pleasure to introduce the next session, which is called Data Science for Health. As Michael already just mentioned, right, this is our third online summit now, which basically means that we are dealing with the corona pandemic for over a year now. I think we're all maybe exhausted, but it is, of course, still a topic on our mind. So we decided to address the elephant in the room and, of course, with data science. And I personally think this can be very empowering because it can help you to understand the data better, to understand predictive models better, but it can also help you to find solutions, for example, in the form of finding new drug candidates. And both of those aspects we will also cover today in the sessions with our two speakers, Elsbeta and Dennis. And first, I would like to introduce Dennis Ganzaroli, who will talk about COVID-19 projections. Dennis is head of report and data management at Swisscom, and he has over 18 years of experience in data science and BI reporting. Welcome, Dennis.
Hi, Jane. Thanks a lot for this opportunity to talk with you.
It's a pleasure to have you. So in the project we want to talk about today, Dennis, you used KNIME in combination with Tableau, but also with Jupyter for projections of COVID-19 case numbers. Tell us a little bit about the project and what were the questions you wanted to answer.
Yes, the goal of my project was to predict the evolution of the COVID-19 cases. In the beginning of the spread, just for China, as it started there, and in the following for every country of the world, mainly for Switzerland, because I'm living there.
That makes sense. Yes. What I find interesting is that you did that project in your spare time, right? So what did motivated you to do so?
Yes, you know, working with data is for me not only a job, it's also a hobby, kind of a passion. Mm-hmm. You know, sometimes people ask me in the social media, what do I need to learn to get a data science job? And then I go to their profile to watch what kind of hobbies they have. And then I answer them, you have to change hobby. Because, yeah, learning is not enough, you know. You have to live it, you have to love it to succeed. But the main motivation of this project was to answer the question, when will be this pandemic over? Yeah? Because as I saw the first videos on YouTube with these long lines of people in front of these Chinese hospitals, I was asking myself, what is going on there? What's happening here? Are we in danger? And so I started to answer these questions by analyzing data. What else? And I found also the official data on the Johns Hopkins Institute, you know, the ones who made this famous dashboard with the red bubbles and the black background. And then I had to find out a way how to calculate the forecast.
Mm-hmm. I think that's for sure something our audience can relate to very well. Yeah. And obviously you decided to use KNIME for this, right? Why?
Yes, it's a good question. Why KNIME? I think the better question would be, what else? I think, you know, it's always a good choice to use KNIME. And the reason is, first, because it's a powerful visual programming tool that helps you focus on the solution instead of the software. And second, it has a lot of plugins now for Python, R, JScript, many, many more. And third, it's open source. Perfect.
Nice. Yeah, and that fits also perfectly to what Michael just said in the beginning of the talk, right? That's like exactly along those lines. Yeah, really, really nice. So you used in this particular project three data science tools, right? Jupyter, Tableau, and obviously all in KNIME.
Yeah.
Can you, I think now everyone wants to see a little bit. Can you share what you...
Yes, I want to show you how I've combined these three tools. I share now my screen. So, and let's go into my kitchen.
So we would like to see the screen sharing now.
You see my screen?
Now it's coming up, yes.
Okay, fine. So here we are on my KNIME Hub site, and you see here is the workflow. Here is also the Jupyter notebook. And let's go to the workflow here. What happens here? First, I loaded the cases from the confirmed cases, the infection cases from the GitHub site of the Johns Hopkins Institute. Here is the link. And then I joined them together with the dev and made some transformations. And after that, I write out a CSV file. So, and thereafter, I call the Jupyter notebook over this Python script here. No? And here happens the magic. And let's see what this Jupyter notebook does. It loads the data from the CSV files, and then here I'm fitting several logistic functions for every country of the world. But the method that I'm using here is, that's a special name, is called Loglet-analysis, and it helps when you have growth processes with several waves. So here I calculate my projections, my forecasts, then I'm again back in KNIME, and I join them together with the basic data, then I make some other transformations, and I upload an Excel file to my Google Drive. And why I do this? Because I'm using the Tableau public version, and this Tableau public version has some limitations. You're able just to refresh data who is on your Google Drive. And here you see the dashboard. I'm updating this dashboard every day now with this workflow that you have seen. And what do we have here? First of all, I want to show you here. Here we can refresh the data, so we get every day fresh data, even if we are using Tableau Public. And there are different KPIs, like the cases, tests. And here you see what happens in Europe. And the most interesting KPI for me is this one. Blue are the effective cases, the actual cases, and orange, the expected cases. As you see, we will have in Europe an increase in the next 30 days. And on the left side, you see different countries and their expected case rates. And you know, red is always bad. And for example, for France, you see there will be an expected case rate increase of 9%. So in 30 days, we will have 9% more infections. And some other countries, they have even more. You can also switch to a dedicated country, like for example, France. Now you see what happens in France. Or you can also change continent, like if you're interested more what's happening in Africa. Here is Africa, or South America, and so on. And you see the evolution of the expected cases there. There are also other KPIs here, but I think these ones are the most interesting. Do you still hear me?
Yes, I do. I hope the audience hears me too. Very, very cool. What I particularly like, it's a really a nice example of mixing and matching technology, and this is obviously one of the big strengths in KNIME.
Actually, this is also a setting that we're using for the every day in our work at Swisscom.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. I'm setting with KNIME and Tableau together.
Mm-hmm. Perfect. Yeah, and we just saw it also a little bit in the talk before. Yes. I think that's really powerful. Yes. So now I think it's time to hand over to Anna, to Constance, and see if there are any questions from the audience.
Oh yes, there is definitely questions from the audience. The first one is, there are two general questions I'm going to merge into one, is why are you using log-like analysis? And the second question is, how did you actually move and manipulate the data from Jupyter to KNIME? So how do you use both tools together?
Yeah. First, to the Loglet analysis. You know, at the beginning of the spread, there was just one wave. No, so a logistic function was good enough to make the forecast. You know, the evolution of a pandemic is like a growth process. So at the beginning, it's like an exponential curve. Well, it's going up. Then it's changing to a sigmoidal curve, and it's more easy to, the logistic regression is the ideal fit for such a process. But then when several waves follow, I had to change my approach. And I found out that the Rockefeller University had already used in the late 90s a method, so-called Loglet analysis, to forecast evolution of multiple overlapping logistic functions, also called wavelets. And I want to share again my screen to show you something.
Can we pull that up again, please? Excellent.
You see my screen?
Yes.
So let's take, for example, this curve here. Huh? It's quite complicated to fit a curve like this, but it could be, for example, the evolution of the COVID-19 cases on several waves. Hmm? That's why it's looking like this. If you decompose such a function, you get two different so-called wavelets, and these wavelets are more easy to fit. And at the end, if you put everything together, you get a very good fit for this curve here, but not only. You can also make a very good forecast. And I want to show you how good this forecast could be. I have here, for example, a tweet, yeah, that I posted on Twitter for the expected cases in Thailand on the 28th of January. As you see, I forecasted in 28th of January that the expected cases would increase very sharp, and then it would stop. We would reach a kind of top of plateau. And a month later, this happened. You know, it happened more or less the same as the model predicted. So I posted this tweet again, another tweet about this topic, and yes, it's. I think it's a very good method for such processes with several waves, like for a pandemic.
Very cool. Yeah, thank you. I think in the interest of time, I would then like take over for the next speaker, just for the audience, those of you who are interested in learning more. Dennis also published his analysis on KDnuggets and on Medium, and he also created a cool YouTube video that I can definitely recommend to watch. And we will share the links also in the follow-up emails, so people can definitely follow up on this one. Thank you so much, Dennis.
Yeah, thank you too. Bye-bye.